हेलो हेलो, यू आर एबल टू हियर मी ना? सो आई कैन स्टार्ट नाउ द प्रोसीडिंग्स।
Hello students, welcome to SuperProfs webinar series. So today's session is on accounting and Professor Sanjay Welkins is live with us right now. Over to Sanjay sir.
Hello, it's a lovely good evening to one and all. As always, hope that each one of you are absolutely fine. So now the examination time is approaching fast, and we have now already come to the end of March, and only 1 month now from here on you can say is remaining. So quite obviously I can feel the heartbeats are rising high, and this is also the time that one should need to actually have lots of what we call calmness to really face and confront this particular paper. And that's exactly what we have here conducting what we call webinar for you, to give you some inputs on the upcoming examination and to actually cool down your rising up beats, heartbeats, and what we call curiosity and anxieties. So hope that each one of you are going to actually dwell a lot after going through this particular webinar, and that's what actually we are here for. So a lovely good evening to one and all, and the names which are flashing down actually my screen, especially Karthik and Shiv and Akash, and to all those actually who right now have joined with us. So as you know, actually we are conducting this particular session specifically and primarily for what we call CA Inter and CA Inter Group 1 and 2, and at the same time for IPCC 1 and 2 students. And those among you actually who are perchance have actually joined with us with respect to CS and CMA, we are going to conduct a separate what we call webinar soon for them. But this one primarily is meant for what we call CA Inter students and IPCC student, of course, group 1 and 2. So basically the basic purpose of conducting this particular webinar is actually to give you some inputs and insights into how to face the examination, which are the area actually where you will have to dwell a lot, where you will have to focus a lot. And obviously, I have seen it through my experience, and almost this particular experience stretches down to more than what we call 2 decades. That is, students sometime actually while writing the answer, actually, they fail to actually meet the parameters which the ICAI is looking for. So we are going to dwell upon those points also, how to give a very striking, smashing answer in the examination to get what we call maximum marks. So we start actually, first of all, we are picking up CA Inter Group 1, and slowly and steadily I will move over to Group 2 also, but some points will remain same. The first point is that actually, first of all, I have seen a student never go through the syllabi very well. So this particular what we call webinar, which I am conducting, will have a mix of both Hindi and English at the same time. Do not worry about this particular fact that so far I haven't used Hindi also. slowly and steady I will come over to that particular point. So I was talking about the fact that initially we are going to pick up first CA intergroup 1, then we are going to pick up CA intergroup 2, and then finally IBCC group 1 and 2. But at the same time, as I said, some points will remain same and you will have to keep an eye focusing. The first thing is that actually I have already told you that we have to be very well acquaint ourselves with, as I said, what we call the syllabi. So if suppose I am a CA intergroup 1 student, I have to go through the syllabus very well. At the same, I have seen actually a student commits lots of mistakes actually, even understanding the syllabi. Why I'm saying so, I've seen actually that a student sometimes skip what we call some important facets, which are basically the part of the syllabus, but later on they repent over the fact that they didn't actually had a look over it earlier. Anyways, first point is that we will cover the focus area. There are many chapters, and if we are going to start off the range of the chapters, then you will find actually lots of what we call new topics you'll find which earlier were not over there because of what we call change in the entire syllabi. Now, the main area which we are going to pick up over here is that which are the chapters which you have to keep an eye for, especially in group one. As far as my experiences, and especially taking into account the what we call past trends, and of course then visualizing it in the context of the future, and in the upcoming examination, we may say actually chapters such as your insurance claim commands very high, what we call ranking as far as priority list is concerned. So you can just pull out a paper and simply write over there, as far as focus area is concerned, insurance is one. Well, you will have to keep an eye for, and you will have to give some extra attention to this particular chapter, insurance. Here I'm writing, if you are able to see this screen, I'm not very sure. I hope you are able to actually see it. Correct? Insurance. And especially if you can see, why I'm actually telling that you have to be very, very what we call deft in understanding a particular chapter's length and breadth. Most of the time, the student actually just take care of facets such as what we call normal insurance question, and similarly loss of profit policy questions, and that's all. If you have gone through what we call lectures very well, we have tried to cover each and every gamut of the chapter. For example, we have covered normal questions on insurance claim. Besides that, even if we have gone through the insurance company's chapter, those among you who have gone through it already so far, they must have noted that I have stressed a lot on questions of abnormal line of goods. So you will have to keep an eye over the questions on abnormal line of goods. Correct? Number one. Number two, loss of profit policy is always important. Please keep a paper along with you and keep on writing, because sometime if I'm going to write, I'm not very sure whether you will be able to watch it or not. So, insurance claim, abnormal line of question, then loss of profit questions, especially question number 21 and 23. But at the same time, questions on computation of insurance policy, this is the area where you need to give the greatest focus. Is it clear to you or not? So, there are some questions which we have added in our what we call material. If you have gone through it, you must have noticed there is a section 4 where questions on calculation of loss of policy amount is given. Some smaller questions have been given. So, loss of profit policy, abnormal line of goods, and questions on calculation of computation of policy. Is it clear to you? Then, of course, I will rate branch account next. It's a pretty long chapter. Branch account, if you have gone through, we have covered and tried to cover almost near about 150 questions. When I say branch, it includes also what we call foreign branches and accounting standard AS 11. In fact, I cannot be choosy out of branch because it's a pretty long chapter, and I keep on saying that you cannot be selective over this particular examination, and you will have to keep track of each and every facet. So you cannot be simply selective, but at the same time, because we are conducting this webinar, basic idea is to keep track of the important, significant and formidable points. And that is the reason actually why I'm trying to tell you that even though branch is very long, I expect this time question on wholesale branch, wholesale branch, independent. And foreign branches. That doesn't mean that I'm telling that you simply should not do what we call data system, stock and data system, in fact, which covers the maximum area of the entire branch chapter. But the fact is that we simply cannot ignore that. We will have to take care of these three parts very well if we really want to have a what we call good crack in the examination. So you have to be very deft, and especially when I say foreign branch, your accounting standard AS11 should be on your desk. Is it clear to you? I have seen actually people ignore departmental account also. So departmental account, you have seen, we have covered it with greatest of depths and lots of questions in it, departmental. And this time you will have to take care of basically questions on markup. We have covered this question. Questions on markup, you simply should not what we call ignore it, because I have seen that a student do sometimes 99% and the most formidable section is ignored out. So that is the reason actually you have to keep an eye over markup concept. I expect a question to strike in the upcoming examination, especially from markup, and to be very honest with you, not less than of 16 marks. Correct? Then, besides markup, besides these three chapters, investment account always holds very high what we call position as far as focus area is concerned. So investment is also very important, and I simply cannot say actually which question you should stress upon, but at the same time, when we say accounting standard, when we say investment, it automatically covers accounting standard 13. Honestly speaking, you cannot expect any question from accounting standard 13, but those among you actually who have our study material, they must have seen actually we have given separately a section on accounting standard investment 30, and you must try to do those questions also. But at the same time, as far as this is accounting standard 13, but besides that, you need to cover up what we call some questions, especially questions where interest-bearing securities are concerned. You can expect a question on interest-bearing securities. Honestly speaking, question could be tossed up either from dividend-bearing securities or interest-bearing securities, but the fact is that I do not know, I have a hunch. I feel that interest-bearing securities is more important than the dividend-bearing securities, but at the same time, you need to understand that actually, as far as accounting treatment is concerned, more or less is absolutely same. So this is a formidable chapter. You again simply cannot neglect. I'm talking about the area of focus where greatest of your what we call time should be consumed when you actually cover up at this particular time. Besides, we have what we call single entry, but I'm not going to rate it very high since it's a very easy chapter. You can easily manage it. Similarly, higher purchase. Not a tough chapter, you can manage it very well. One or two questions are more than enough at this particular moment to revise the entire chapter. So now we move over to partnership. This is area where you need to dwell very high partnership. I have a hunch that amalgamation of partnership has got a very high chance to strike in the examination. And besides that, we expect a sale of partnership, and the topic which generally the student fraternities care of, that is piecemeal distribution. You should take care of this particular facet also. Piecemeal distribution. So amalgamation, sale, piecemeal distribution, of course, topics prior to these ones are quite easy: solvency, insolvency, and partners' insolvency. So your area of focus at this particular moment should be confined to these three what we call parts of partnership. Your scoring area, and a theoretical question could be asked from LLP, limited limited liability partnership? A theoretical question could be asked on this particular topic, so be careful. A theory question could be asked, what are limited liability partnerships? So you should have a little bit of idea regarding this particular topic also. Is it clear to you? So these are the focus area. And then we come over to what we call profit prior to incorporation. Profit prior to incorporation, I have seen actually students sometimes feel it's an easy chapter, so we can manage it very easily. But this chapter could become complicated if you are not going to actually have a what we call high amount of in-depth and insightful knowledge regarding all the principles. So profit prior to incorporation, you should not neglect it. This is the chapter I am rate quite high. Even if a 16-mark question is asked from this particular topic, that should not what people put you in a surprising moment. This chapter is very good chapter, and because some new chapters have been added, you simply cannot ignore them. Of course, redemption of preference shares. A question could be asked. A smaller question could be asked from this particular section. See, actually, they are going to cover almost every chapter. But at the same time, not rated very high, but because it is a new chapter, newly added chapter, earlier it wasn't the part of what we call CA inter level. So because it is newly added, you can expect a question. And bonus issue, simple, so not very time consuming one. Redemption of preference share bonus issue. But this chapter, final account. When I say final account, it also contains cash flow statement and managerial remuneration. So you should have a good look over this particular chapter, especially the cash flow statement, and especially last four questions of our study material, where we have stressed upon preparation of the cash flow statement and where income statement is given. So you should be little bit more careful about those questions. Similarly, with respect to managerial remuneration, because new provisions have already struck up, so you need to have a good knowledge, especially the last question of R, what we call course, you need to do that. And as far as preparation of financial statement is concerned, that's quite easy. So I don't think any question will be asked from that particular area, but cash flow statement and managerial remuneration is quite important. Now coming over to the accounting standard part, as far as accounting standard part is concerned, there are lots of accounting standard at this particular level. Accounting standard 1 is part of your course, 2 inventory valuation, 3 will be covered along the cash flow statement as you must have seen. Then accounting standard 4, that is related to, as you know, either certainly after the date of balance sheet and profit prior to income, and this is net profit for the period. Then accounting standard 10, correct? So this is, I'm going to put up a red mark down over here just to let you know. I think you are not able to watch it because I will have to take care of the limits which is set upon by the camera. So I will write it over here rather than, I think it is not needed. Is it needed? Are you noting it down also? Well, I will write it over here. Accounting standard 1, 2, 3, and 3 is already covered along the cash flow statement. Accounting standard 4, 5, then we have 10, 11. 11 is already covered along with foreign branches. Then accounting standard 12, related to government grants, 13 is investment accounting standard. Then 16 is borrowing cost, and accounting standard 17 is segment reporting, and 22, it will be said to you within this particular week. Accounting standard AS22, it will be uploaded soon in this week itself, so you need not require to worry about that. But these are the accounting standard 22, very important. Accounting standard 16, 12, 17, you can expect a very high length question. Go through the segment reporting very well because you can expect it. Question containing very high amount of marks from this particular section. Then accounting standard 16, borrowing cost, and 12. Because accounting standard 13 will be covered along with investment, you need not require to put up any extra time. Similarly, accounting standard 11 will be covered along with foreign branches. You need not require to put up any extra time, as I said. And similarly, cash flow statement is given along with what we call cash flow. But here the students sometimes commit mistake. I have given some questions on accounting standard, and that particular, those questions have been collaborated with the chapter itself. So go through those questions. So I'm very sure you will be able to come out with flying color. Now, rest of the accounting standard are simple, but the most important is accounting standard AS10. Most important is accounting standard AS10. It has been uploaded, and recently I have uploaded in my YouTube also. Sorry, in the YouTube also through my channel. So you can go through accounting standard AS10 very well. I'm very sure that you will get some new insights into what we call accounting standard AS10, because property, plant, and equipment, because it is a lengthy, high profile, and in a revamped manner, obviously, examiners are going to take care of accounting standard AS10, 17, 16, 22, because earlier these were not part of what we call group one. So automatically, because of their addition, their significance will rise. And accounting standard 22, which I'm going to upload very soon within this particular week, I can promise, not worry about that. So you will get a good idea regarding AS22. So these are the what we call areas where you will have to put up maximum efforts. I'm sure actually, if you can do so and manage that way around, so you can come out with flying colors. Often I have seen, since first of all, we are talking about what we call area, focus area, and next now the segment is how to present a very deadly answer in the examination to attract the high amount of attention. It is very important. Unless and until your presentation will be of supreme quality, examiner is not going to actually give you the sort of mark which you always expect. So that's the reason actually, even you must have noticed through our tutorials, through the tutorials which are sent to you by SuperProfs, of course, you must have noticed that whenever I solve the question, I take care of one important fact, that the answer should be in sequence. And generally, I adopt a procedural policy of step one, step two, step three, something like that. And this is exactly what I would love you to actually do. Basic intention of the student should be to give a proper sequenced answer. One part must adhere to the earlier part. There must be some synchronization. That is very important. For example, suppose if you are delivering an answer to the profit prior to incorporation, step number A should be, first of all, analytical diagram. You must make a diagram. Remember one thing, you are not going to lose anything. And also don't let it escape out of your memory that ICI doesn't stop you from being creative. In fact, sometimes your creativity could actually fetch you very high amount of returns. That's the reason actually I keep on actually harping upon the same string, that sequence is the most formidable section of your solution. So step number one, I'm just giving one example. For example, you are solving profit prior to incorporation. Step number one should be your diagrammatic presentation. Step number two should be, of course, calculation of your what we call sales ratio and C, time ratio. And if there are some adjustments, we need what we call extra workings. Then step by solve those, and then finally you prepare the statement of preliminary statement of profit and loss account. That should be the part. Similarly, if you are solving, let us say, an equation for wholesale branch account, first of all, step number A should be actually analysis of risk. Correct? Then you prepare what we call the ledger accounts in the books of the head office. Then you what we call prepare a ledger account in the books of the branch office. Then leave some space for what we call calculation of, because some workings will be needed over there, calculation of closing stock and something like that. Main point is that unless and until you are going to adopt a sequential what we call way of solving the question, you will not be able to reflect your confidence. Basically, examination and the examiner and the ICI, what they are looking for. They are looking for your conceptual clarity, and conceptual clarity, guess what we call, reflected by a very confident answer, and the confident answer's proof lies in a sequential answer. If you are confident, then only you will be able to give a good sequence to the solution. That is very important. Similarly, independent branch, your first step should be reconciliation, if you remember, isn't it or not? After having done the reconciliation of the branch account balance and what we call the head office balance, then we actually make a revised trial balance, then what we will pass the incorporation entries, and finally we prepare the consolidated balance sheet. Similarly, in the departmental markup, actually, if you remember, First of all, it is always better to analyze the question thoroughly. You must write what we call the rates analysis. Your should be first step. Then you start the ledger accounts. What my point ultimately, which boils down to, is that there should be a perfect sequence. Now coming over to the standard, because this is the area where you need to be very, very, what we call alert, to give a very good, solid answer. I have told on umpteenth occasion, for example, if you are writing any answer, say for accounting standard AS4, must mention step number one, that facts of the present case are covered by accounting standard AS4. Then point number two, relate that situation which is related to the point which is given and the guideline which is given in the accounting standard. For example, you will have to write under step number two that this particular case can be termed as a case of adjustment item or non-adjustment item according to the situation which is given in the question. Then you talk about that particular situation which the guideline states. For example, if it is an adjustable situation, then you simply write that since that particular event has taken place prior to the approval of the account, it is an adjustment item, and then you talk about what should be the treatment. As per this particular standard, so and so should be the treatment. So must, while writing the answer, especially with respect to the standard, you have to be careful that step number one and two are very important, because those two steps are going to tell to the examiner that whether the student is really very well aware of what we call the guideline of the standard or not. For example, if the first two points you have related, if you have written at the last, it is not going to be of much benefit to you. So that is the reason first two points are very important. But at the same time, there will be some standards like accounting standard 12, 16, 17, and 10, where you will simply have to solve the particular question. So these are the things, minor things, which you will have to keep track of. Is it clear to you or not? So these are the focus area, how to give a very deadly smashing, what we call glint to your answer, so that examiner it remains bewitched and he feels out of his heart to give you maximum marks. Is it clear to you? We talked about group one first, correct? And now we will come over to group two. As far as group two CA Inter is concerned, obviously some new chapters have been added. So quite obviously those chapters definitely will command very high amount of what we call attention from you. And we on our side have done level best effort to give you the best. And last month only we have uploaded, actually, to be very honest with you, because we wanted to give you the best possible what we call teachings and tutorials. I hope you would accept. I would love to have your feedback on that. So those area where you will have to keep an eye for, one is holding company, that is known as accounts of consolidated, that is known as consolidated accounts. Holding company, accounts of holding companies, and sometimes you say it, consolidated accounts. Very, very important. I'm dead sure that you will have a 16 mark question from this topic. This is the only surety which I can give you, to be very honest with you. You know, at this particular level, it is very, very difficult to give you anything with great surety, but through my experience and through the trend and through the length and breadth of this particular chapter and the formidability which it contains, one can simply say that this is the chapter which will definitely have a question in the examination. Holding companies. Obviously, then you must give an eye and extra attention to NBFC, non-banking finance company. Non-banking finance company, some small questions may be asked. Is it clear to you or not? So non-banking finance company and especially questions on provision. And the last question, if you remember, actually, I have done a last question, and which is very, very important, where we talked about higher purchase installments, if you remember. And if you haven't, then please go through that. And then mutual funds, very important again. Valuation of goodwill. These are the four chapters which have been added. And these are the four chapters which will command the highest level of what we call, one should command highest level of focus, quite obviously. Isn't it or not? And then, besides these four chapters that you will have to take care of, amalgamation and internal reconstruction. Amalgamation and internal reconstruction. These two chapters will definitely need high amount of focus because amalgamation is very lengthy and at the same time, some people feel very what we call complicated. I'm not very sure of you. I hope that each one of you feel what we call quite easy. Correct? And then, besides what we call mutual funds, besides internal reconstruction, then these are the chapters which are very important, and then we can say that you have some chapters like buyback. Your first priority should be towards these four chapters, then towards these chapters, and finally toward these chapters, buyback and underwriting. Buyback, underwriting. But at the same time, liquidation also, you simply cannot ignore it off. Liquidation of companies and redemption of debenture. However, when you will go through redemption of debenture, you need to take care of only what we call three aspects. That is conversion aspect, number one. And second, what we call purchase from the open market, and especially through X interest, term interest case, which we did. Correct? Which we have done, in fact. So, only these two topics are vital, conversion and this. What about holding company? Initial, you start off, since you have already completed the chapter, I presume that you have completed already, then you take the question in between 20 to 25, or should I say in between 15 to 25, correct? At this particular level and at this particular point of time, questions from 15 to 29 are quite important. Here you cannot be choosy because NBFC hardly contains what we call 7-8 questions. Mutual funds also contains what we call 9-10 questions. But valuation of goodwill you can expect. So these two chapters, these are the chapter holding company, valuation of goodwill, amalgamation, internal reconstruction, liquidation, and redemption of debenture, where your area of focus should be very high, and you should stress what we call all these chapters, simply because that these are the chapters which I marked down. They may have the what we call gap, where from what we call 16 mark question could be actually asked in the examination. But at the same time, you must not actually forget that you have these chapters in your, as a part of your course, so you will have to keep an eye over this. Now, sir, you haven't talked about anything banking and insurance. Aren't they very important? Honestly speaking, if I were given a choice, I would simply tell you go through these chapters after having done this. Banking, banking. Because by now you have already gone through these chapters so well and so many times that you are already well acquainted with the what we call accounting facets of this particular chapter. Is it clear to you or not? You are already, just hold on, so there is some well, I will take the questions very soon, don't worry about that, but at least give me some time. I can hear you, I can see the messages from, but just wait for a while. First, let me finish it off. I do not know actually. Well, I will go through the question, don't worry about that, but give me some time at this particular moment. My point here is that banking company, insurance company, because the student always feel whenever we do banking company and insurance company, the student itself are so focused at that time itself that they are quite well versed with the what we call accounting policies of this particular what we call chapter. Since I have written it at fourth level, that doesn't mean that they are not important. But what my point is that since you are already well deft with the accounting policies and the accounting matters of these chapters, that you need not require any extra efforts. However, the last section of insurance company where you may be asked a question on entries and ledgers of what we call reserve for unexpired risk. Correct? Especially question number 13 and 14 of insurance company you must take care of, and banking company. First five topics are okay, rebates, performing asset, non-performing assets, ECGC coverage and preparation of financial statement, etc. But the area of focus should be what we call capital adequacy ratio and the last question which we did. is it clear at the last section which we did? So all in all, I would say that your area should be, area of focus should be towards such areas which are not quite what we call frequent, where you feel that question cannot come from. And the fact of the matter is that especially the examiner are hunting for such area which earlier haven't been very favorite with the examiners, but now they have become. That is what my point is. Is it clear to you or not? So these are the things which you have to keep. And I have already told you prior to this particular session and segment that how to give a very good look to your answer, how, what exactly is the way. I need not require to repeat those things. And time and again, I keep on telling to the student that first and foremost thing is that your answer and solution should reflect your confidence. And your confidence gets what we call reflected when you give a good sequence, good order to the solution. And good order and solution can come only with the required practice and with thorough understanding of the concepts. Needless to add that we, whatever question which we have done in the class, you must have noted down, we adhere to a particular what we call programmed, you can say, sequence. For example, if you pick up any question from holding company, the first step will be calculation of analysis of what we call analysis of accounting period. Then we generally go for what we call computation of degree of control. Then step number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, something like that. So whenever you write, your answer should reflect a good sequence, and examiner must feel that second part is attached with the first one and there is a complete good harmony and what we call synchronization. That is where what we call examiner tend to feel that the student is really confident about what he is doing, what he is presenting, and his presentation is reflective of his understanding. Then that's the reason why examiner will become internally very happy to give you a very high amount of marks. So these are the tricks and traits of what we call presenting a good mark, which we have already, which we always adopt to, even while what we call giving you the tutorials. And now coming over to the last segment, what we call accounting standard. If you have seen actually as far as accounting standard is concerned, now accounting standards 7 and 9 have become part of your syllabus, as you know already. Accounting standard, and then 14, we have already covered that along with amalgamation. Accounting standard 18 and accounting standard 24 will be uploaded this week. Even though it is given to you, but I have revised it and I will upload it in this week itself. So you need not require to worry about that. And accounting standard in between there were 19 and 20, which I haven't written. And then 26 and 29. Which are the standards which need to be focused upon? Honestly speaking, these two standards are quite easy. When you will go through it, you will feel that these are the smallest and easiest. All these standards, especially 19, 20, 26, and 29, are very, very important. And you can expect simple, straight question where you need not require to write any theory, to be very honest with you, because these standards come on. All, these are almost like a practical question. And 7 and 9, here, from question number 7, here you will be given a practical and you will simply solve it. Again, no theory is required, but in question number 9, accounting standard 9, you will have to give a theoretical answer that is almost like a case study. And I just told earlier that especially when you deliver the answer to accounting standard, then the first two steps are very vital where you should tell to the examiner that you are aware of the fact that where from these standards have been taken from, or where these facts are from, to which standard they relate. Then, after going through